Okay, Ayurveda. I am sipping some water with some herbs. It's warm water with herbs. And the herbs that I'm drinking are gajuchi and gugulu. These are Ayurvedic medicinal herbs, and they are really delightful. Just a little sprinkle to help relieve any kind of oncoming signs of arthritis, any kind of joint pain. I was traveling from last week till yesterday, and I didn't bring them with me, so I'm getting a little creaky. And it's powerful how efficacious these combination of herbs are. If you have any interest in learning more about medicinal herbs, send me a DM. I can share some with you that are very simple and not very easy to take, not super contraindicated for any other medicines that you might be on. But I can advise you about that personally if you're interested, and happy to share my practice with you, and I can send you more information about how you can do that in a more formal way as well. But today, Ayurveda, I wanted to talk about travel, because as things are opening up, maybe you are traveling, maybe you are starting to get on airplanes, you're starting to travel far and wide, the world is opening and closing actually in some areas. But some of us have been traveling this summer, and I just want to share ways for you to ease the stress of travel on our bodies, emotion in a car, in a train, in an airplane is vata provoking. So vata means air, wind, movement, and that can cause havoc on our bodies. Just in general, vata is the queen of all the doshas and really rules the movement of the other doshas. So it's an important one to understand, especially when we're traveling. So when we have this forward motion of travel, moving, bodies don't really catch up with that kinetic force, and it can disrupt our digestive organs. It can cause a whole lot of other problems too. It can create some dryness in the body, as our body just can't lubricate enough to recover, because our digestive organs are really needing more attention. So the whole body just sort of polarizes all of the systems to help our digestion. So what you want to do when you travel, if you're on an airplane, if you're going on a long road trip, is fasting. So I say this with caution, because I know some of you are, maybe you're diabetic and you have to manage your blood sugar levels in a very intentional way. So please use what I'm saying with caution. Of course, you know your own body. Your body is unique and you know yourself best. But sips of water the night before you go traveling, very light breakfast, light on the body, sips of water throughout your trip. Stay away from coffee while you're traveling, and really allow the digestive system to be open and spacious. Don't have a heavy meal. Have something light. Vegetables, some fruit. You want to just make sure you're able to keep lightness in the body. Now, if it comes to pass that you're feeling a little, a little hungry, you need to settle your tummy even if you get motion sickness, then by all means have something salty to eat. And something lightly grounding, like bread or a saltine, a cracker, something light that can help you. that can help settle your tummy. Salty, lightly cooked vegetables, like steamed vegetables in a little thermos, carrying that with you can help to nourish you and keep your body grounded during this time of travel. It will help to stimulate your digestion with fiber. And when you get where you're going, you might feel a lot better if you take these practices in action. If you're going on an international flight, these are really great tips, because having a fast before your trip can help you arrive in good shape without a lot of digestive problems. It happens a lot when we get older to have digestive issues when we are traveling. And you want to minimize that so you can enjoy the people that you're with without feeling ill, at ease. And that's my sharing with you around Ayurveda and travel. Thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful, wonderful day.